Hey guys, and welcome to the Corner Lot Lawn. Yes, I'm sitting out here in the middle of my lawn with my cat supervisor in the corner, and I'm getting ready to forage my very first thing of the year, which is wild onions slash wild garlic. They're pretty much the same thing. Wild onions are hollow on the leaves. Wild garlic is not. So I believe this is wild onion. I usually get them when they're pretty young, so sometimes it's really hard to tell. But when people ask me, what should I forage and what should I start with, I always suggest wild onion slash wild garlic because they're always easy to identify and usually people know what they are anyways. And I always get tons of questions of, are wild onions in my yard edible? Yes, yes they are. And if you're going to start foraging, the best place to start foraging is in your yard. So let me show you what to look for. So this is what the plant looks like. And just for the sake of simplicity, I'm just going to call them wild onions because they smell like onions, whether they're wild garlic or wild onions. And if you snip one off, it smells like an onion. And really, that is what you're going for. If it smells like onion, it's edible. Period. If it smells like onion, it's edible. So it's very easy to forage wild onions. Excuse me. Wild onions, because if it smells like onions, you know you're safe. If it doesn't smell like onions, don't eat it. It's another type of bulb. And that's just it. That's all you need to know. Smell it. Yep, that's onions, definitely. And you can pull up the bulbs. The bulbs are edible too. But what I do is I just snip off the greens. And I snip them off, I put them in a big bowl, and then I get inside and I pull out like the dead ones or leaves or whatever. I happen to get pieces of grass, I get in with it. And then I snip them up and I put them in a gigantic mason jar and I put them in my freezer. And then throughout the year when I have a recipe that calls for green onions or chives, I just pull these out and use it. But of course, I don't have to do that. Wild onions pretty much grow around here year round. I just do it for simplicity because it's easier for me to go to my freezer than run out into the yard and hunt down onions because it might be raining or snow or whatever. So this is how I forage them. So here's just my little patch of onions, and I just take them, and I've got my scissors. I could use my hands too, but I like to just use my scissors, just chop them off down at the base, and there you go, just like snipping chives. I want to talk about these right here. Now this is the fence line to my neighbor's property. And there's some onions right here that I could harvest, but I'm not going to because my neighbor uses weed killer and chemicals on her lawn. And I just don't want that in my system. So I'm just going to leave these be. I've got plenty others in my lawn. And that's what you got to know. Do not harvest stuff from a place that uses chemicals. Like if you're going to a public park, be careful, because they may use chemicals on that grass. So know where you are foraging. That's why I say in your backyard, you know what you put on your grass. It's always best to get these kind of things in your backyard if you can. Always forage your own land if you can. How many times can I say if you can? But yeah, be careful with that. Don't forage near the road because chemicals from the cars and stuff like that gets in the soil. You don't want that. Don't forage near your neighbor's property if they use chemicals on their lawn, because that could come over into your lawn. So just be careful. Now this is over near my compost, as you can see. Got some good old lushness going here. And that's what's good about snipping, because I can just snip these off right above the line and I don't have to worry about getting this in with my onions. Okay, here is my results for today. As you see, I got some really big ones and I got some tiny ones. And yes, I got some dandelion blooms, but that's for something else. But they were blooming, so I thought I'd go ahead and get a start on that. This is for dandelion jelly. And yes, I will show you about that probably next. So I'm going to take these in. I'm going to wash them off. I'm going to put them in my jars and in my freezer. If you have any questions, just hit me up below. Otherwise, I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.
Follow me on YouTube, follow me on Twitter, follow me on Facebook, follow me on Instagram, follow me on Pinterest, follow me on Twitch, follow me on MySpace. What the hell is MySpace? Follow me on Musical.ly, follow me on Reddit, follow me on the sidewalk, follow me on the road, follow me on WhatsApp, follow me on Dailymotion. Follow, follow, follow.